Hi, I'm Janek Gwizdala. If you are new to the channel, I want to let you know why this channel is here, how any of us can accomplish anything in music we want, and what it is exactly that goes into that process. There are no tips, tricks, hacks, or shortcuts to becoming good at music. Musicians don't go beast mode, and there simply isn't one scale that changes everything or makes you the master of anything. There is, however, an amazing journey to take, and for almost three decades, that has been my entire life. There is perhaps no more valuable a commodity than your time. So my job, my role here in creating this content for you is very simple. To be honest with you about the process and to help you not just become a better musician or bass player, but to help you ask better questions about what it is you want to learn, to challenge what you hear and see on the internet, and to help you improve the efficiency of your practice routine. As you heard at the beginning of the video, we're working on pentatonics today and how they can be applied to both your creation of bass lines and to your melodic content. Let me preface this exercise by highlighting the fact that it is simply a tool to practice repetition. It's a basic framework made up of components based on real-world musical situations. When it comes to learning any style of playing or any specific musical sound, immersion in that style and sound is probably the biggest key to your success in becoming fluent with that vocabulary. Okay, it is ad time. This video is not sponsored by Squarespace or Skillshare, but I'm going to take this 20 seconds to sponsor it with my own book, with the source of all the material you're hearing in this video. It's The Bass Player's Guide to Pentatonics. It is linked below in the description of the video. It's available in physical form, just like this. Ooh, that feels nice. At Amazon.com and in digital form at JanekGwizdala.com. Both formats come with over 50 playalongs and a bunch of video companions. It's all in standard notation and tab for bass players. Now, let's get back to the show. When I think of great bass players who play this way and use pentatonics like this, my immediate references are people I'm sure you've spent a lot of time listening to, like Marcus Miller, Victor Wooten, Michel Andeguicello, Stanley Clarke, Jaco Pastorius. The list is long. The biggest takeaway for me with all of these musicians is the ease with which they execute their ideas and express themselves to their audience. And I've found that through practicing with the right intent, focusing more on time and sound, almost more than anything else, and through as much repetition as your sheer willpower will allow, this is where the real work takes place. This is what sets great musicians and storytellers apart from everyone else. So what am I doing with the pentatonic scale in this video? It's a very simple premise. It's a four-bar phrase. The first two bars are the same chord in the same bass line every time. The second two bars of the phrase are a melodic statement where the chord changes underneath it. We're going through seven different chord qualities for the melodic phrase at the end of the sequence. The bass line is composed of notes from C minor pentatonic, and the melodic phrase is also exclusively notes from C minor pentatonic, but that quality of that chord changes every time, seven different iterations. And the purpose of all this is to get you comfortable knowing that you can play in this one sound melodically, and it will fit with so many different harmonic contexts. So let's get to it. This is one iteration of the entire cycle, seven phrases, always the same bass line, always the same melodic phrase. Thank you. So a couple of things about that. Number one, really important to take that and do it in all 12 keys. It's really good to be so in control of that sound everywhere on your instrument. Super, super important. That's number one. Second thing is, as you're about to hear in the next portion of the video, the next portion of me playing this idea, is that you should really start using this just as a starting point. As with everything in this book, it's just a starting point. It's just a suggestion to get you going to the next place and to get your brain thinking about, okay, well, if I can do this, then why can't I do that? Now, experiment, push the boundaries of what these written examples give you. That's exactly what I'm gonna do now. It's just taking that second phrase, that melodic phrase, and instead of playing what's written, playing around with C minor pentatonic, but getting used to where all of those notes fit on those different chords, the seven different chords in the second half of each phrase. So that's it. That's the lesson. It's now on you to move these around in 12 keys, to get so comfortable and natural with this sound, with this vocabulary, that you start to be able to pick that out. When you listen to Marcus Miller and you hear Marcus Miller playing a bass line, and then you hear him play a fill, and you can be, oh, I hear minor pentatonic content there. Of course, it's not just one scale, there are hundreds. It's not just one chord, there are many. But this is one small part of helping you understand and helping you hear music in real time and access all of these other things that perhaps you haven't been able to up until this point. So hopefully we got somewhere towards that. And I really appreciate you sticking around this long. If you made it this far in the video, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. That really helps. Hit the thumbs up. That helps the algorithm game. I've never been a great player of the game, but I know it helps. And if you want to see more free content like this, I would really appreciate it. You hit the thumbs up. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you would like to hear about next. Maybe you have Bass Player's Guide to Pentatonics already. If you don't, it's linked below. Don't forget. Maybe you want to hear about another concept in this book. Maybe you want to hear about another concept in one of my other books or something you heard on a record. Leave it in the comments below. That's a gold mine in terms of you giving me your feedback and us getting to some common ground. So I appreciate you sticking around, and I'll see you on the next one.